Hello everyone. Hopefully by now you should have a pretty good understanding of the basics of note value and time signature. Today I'm going to talk about a concept that's a little bit more advanced, and that is called dotted rhythms. And you may just want to grab something to write with, since we're going to do some thorough analysis and breakdowns of different rhythms. So here I have just a regular quarter note, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a dot beside it. And what this dot does is that it extends the original note by half of its duration. So this rule is actually very important in music, and I hope by the end of this video, after several examples, you will have a practical and thorough understanding of it. So let's go back and look at our quarter note that now has a dot attached to it. What can I conclude about its duration? Well, let's do a little math here. We know that the dot extends the original note by half of its duration. And since the original note here is a quarter note, it means that the dot extends it by half of a quarter note. And we know that a quarter note is equal to 2/8 notes. Therefore, half of a quarter note is just 1/8 note. So the total length of a quarter note that has a dot attached to it, or you can call it a dotted quarter note, is just 3/8 notes, or a quarter note plus an eighth note. Let's do another example. So here I have a half note with a dot to it, and I encourage you to pause the video and ask yourself first, what is the duration of this thing? Well, as you have probably already guessed, the duration of this is just 3/4 notes. So how do we get this? Well, since half of a half note is a quarter note, and 1/2 note equals to 2/4 notes, and we would have 2 + 1/4 notes, which is 3/4 notes. Now, things are going to get tricky in our next example. Here, I have incorporated everything we have learned so far, note values, time signature, and dotted rhythms into one example. It might look a bit daunting at first, but I'm sure it won't take you much time before grasping these skills to do it. So let's first sort out the bars we should have no problem with. Here, here, and here. These are just very basic rhythms. So now let's look at the rest of this example. One of the most practical and helpful tricks I like to do when I see a quite complicated bar or measure is I always write out the subdivisions based on the shortest note value in the measure. So for example, since the shortest note value in the second measure is an eighth note, I'm going to write out my subdivisions in eighth notes. And since our time signature is 2/4, it means that every measure is made out of 2/4 notes. Therefore, I'm going to subdivide it into 4/8 notes. After doing so, the rhythm becomes very clear. The dotted quarter notes, as we just discovered, equals to 3/8 notes. So when you are playing this measure, you can just count 3/8 notes and think of the subdivisions. The next measure seems even more daunting, but I'm going to use the same method to help me with it. Since the shortest note value here is the 16th note, I'm going to write my subdivisions in 16th notes. Now, let's look at this guy right here. You might not have seen it before. So the front part is just an eighth note with a dot, or you can call it dotted eighth note. And to get its duration, you just add half of an eighth note to the original eighth note. And we know that half of an eighth note is just a 16th note. Therefore, it equals to 3/16th notes. And of course, when you're playing this passage, it will be very helpful for you to think about these subdivisions. Now, you might be thinking, oh man, this process takes forever, and what if I have a very long passage? Well, the truth is, as you practice more and play more music, the process of writing subdivisions by the shortest note value can be done in your head. However, once you have this skill, it will help you so much in the future in terms of rhythmic accuracy. Finally, without further ado, let's tackle this example. I encourage you to try it on your own first. And remember to always think about the subdivisions we just did. So let me just take a relatively moderate tempo here. Finally, let's conclude our video with a real music example of dotted rhythms. Here I have for you the opening of Bach's famous Chaconne in D minor for the violin. And the entire page is basically written with dotted rhythms. And this is also how you know that it's very important to know this.
Thank you.